Hey guys, John here of AMC Entertainment's Script to Screen. You know, there's Matthew Vaughn has become a director that I really respect. His film that he had out this year, Kick-Ass, is probably going to end up in my top five favorite films of the year. He directed what I consider to be probably the most underrated film of the last decade with Stardust. And as of right now, he's on to direct, and I say as of right now because with Matthew Vaughn, one never knows with superhero films, but right now he's on to direct the next X-Men film, X-Men First Class. Now, Matthew just recently said some fairly controversial things about the comic book genre, and here to discuss those comments that Matthew made, I'm joined, first of all, by senior editor from joblo.com, Mr. Mike Sampson. Mike, how you doing?
Good, John. How are you?
I'm great, thanks. And we're also joined by a regular around here from Latino Review, El Guapo, George Roush. George, how you doing?
Good, buddy. How are you?
I'm doing well. And we're also joined by somebody who's going to have an interesting perspective on this, along with his creative partner, Mark Neville Dean. He is they are the writers and directors of the Jason Statham Crank films, and it's recently been announced that they're going to be directing the new Ghost Rider 2 with Nicolas Cage. I'm joined by Mr. Brian Taylor. Brian, how you doing?
What's up? Hey, can I get a cool name like El Guapo?
You got to earn that, pal.
Yeah.
Hey,
awesome.
Now, listen, before we start talking about this, let me just read the quote that Matthew Vaughn made. Now, of course, we know Matthew Vaughn was on to direct a previous X-Men film. He was going to do the third X-Men film, backed out of that. I believe, and correct me if I'm wrong here, guys, I believe at one point he was on to direct Thor, if I'm not mistaken. Before he walked away from that one as well. But this is what he had to say this week about the state of the comic book genre and why he's decided to do X-Men First Class. He said, "I've always wanted to do a big budget superhero film, and I think we've kind of crossed the Rubicon with superhero films. I think the opportunity to do one, it's only going to be there two or three more times. Then the genre is going to be dead for a while because the audience has just been pummeled too much." George, let's start with you. What is your first reaction, your first thoughts on Matthew Vaughn's comments?
Well, I don't know what he's getting at. I mean, every genre goes through stages, and they're all still alive pretty much except for the Western. But I don't know where he's getting at. I don't know why he thinks that the audiences are going to get burned out on superhero movies. It's not like there's, you know, one every single month. That's just like audiences getting burned out on romantic comedies. It just hasn't happened yet. And superhero movies consist of everything you want in a film. You know, action, love, drama. I mean, they've got everything there. And with the technology and storytelling only getting better, I don't see superhero movies going away anytime soon.
Mike, your thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, I'm with George, really. I mean, I'm not sure where he was coming from with that remark, but I think that, you know, it ebbs and flows. And I think, like, horror movies after when Scream first came out, the kind of teen horror genre kind of came in and sort of played itself out a little bit, but then it started to come back, and, you know, we're starting to see a lot of those types of movies again. And I mean, I wouldn't say that the superhero genre really is anything like the teen horror genre, but I think that, you know, there's always going to be room for good movies, and I think the genre has shown that there are going to be some stinkers, but there are also going to be some really great movies that are involved in there. And as long as the quality stays, I don't see the interest waning at all. I think actually the opposite. I think it's, you know, just as popular as ever. So I'm not really sure that I understand where he was coming from.
Brian, you're a guy who's not only on the inside with making films, but you've got a superhero film that you're developing now. What are your thoughts on these comments?
Well, I mean, it really does come down to good movies. I think bad superhero movies are not going to work, and good superhero movies are going to work. You know, it comes down to, it's something I've talked to with a lot of people about. You know, there seems to be a conception that because the genre is super hot right now, you can put somebody in a costume with a little bit of pre-awareness and throw them out there and spend some money on CG, and it's going to be a blockbuster. And I think there's some things in the pipeline right now that are going to prove that wrong. But on the other hand, look at where Batman was before Nolan took it over.
Right.
People thought of it completely differently. It was sort of silly. You know, it was Schwarzenegger as Mr. Freeze and all that stuff, and it was kind of you know, it had become something, you know, kind of ridiculous. And all it really takes is a fresh take on it. I mean, we just saw Scott Pilgrim the other day. I feel like that's a superhero movie.
It does feel that way, doesn't it? Yeah.
It does, and it's a totally different take on it. So, I mean, there's always going to be room for, you know, some fresh take on it that takes people by surprise.
Now, George, you and Mike mentioned that I have a thought on this, and I'm curious what you guys think about this. You know, patterns come and go. You know, 3D is hot, and then it goes away. It's come back. It's gone away. Now it's back again. It's been around for a while. The superhero genre came, and Brian, you mentioned, I believe, that the title of the film was Batman and Robin, which pretty much is universally accepted the film that killed the superhero genre for a while. And, you know, for a long time, I've kind of been expecting the same sort of thing to happen, that we just need a really high-profile dud to hit, and then that'll kill the superhero genre for a while. And when Fantastic Four came out, I thought we had it. But the superhero genre endured. And then Fantastic Four 2 came out, and I thought, well, this time for sure. I mean, you know, the Fantastic Four battling a French Ferris wheel, that's got to kill the superhero genre. But it hasn't. It's just kept enduring and enduring and enduring through duds, through some bad films. Now, we've had some great films, some fantastic superhero films, but we've also had a lot of duds. Mike, why has the superhero genre endured through a lot of these duds, whereas back a few years ago, it couldn't endure once Batman and Robin hit?
Well, I mean, I think there's more chances now. The superhero genre is a little more proven. I think back when Batman and Robin was around, there wasn't a whole lot of, metal behind all of this. I mean, there weren't really a lot of big success stories other than the Batman franchise. Prior to that, maybe Superman. But now, I mean, I just think that there's other things to fall back on. So now it's, before the success was the exception, now the dud is the exception. There aren't really, you know, you get a dud, but then you also get a movie like Iron Man or the newer Incredible Hulk and some movie, and, you know, the Spider-Man movies, with the exception of the third one. So, I mean, I think that it can get past that, you know. So what if you have, even Iron Man 2 is a great example, not a great movie, but I guarantee you if they announced Iron Man 3 tomorrow, the awareness and the excitement for that movie would be just as high as if Iron Man 2 was a great movie. I think people are willing to kind of look past Iron Man 2 for what it was, and we'll look forward to the Avengers, and we'll look forward to Iron Man 3 and future movies like that.
Brian, was there any discussion when you and Mark Neville Dean were in talks about Ghost Rider 2, was there ever, did the idea ever come up that, oh, maybe this shouldn't be done because we think the superhero movie has almost run its course? Was that ever even a part of the discussion?
No. Not at all. I mean, our only reticence towards Ghost Rider 2 was really Ghost Rider 1.
Right.
Which, to us, you know, actually Nick has about the best take on that movie that I've ever heard. And after hearing his take, I watch it again and I kind of enjoy it, which is that it was sort of like a 60-0 Walt Disney take on the character. like if Walt Disney, and this is the Walt Disney, this is not the Pixar Disney, this is the Disney of like Davy Crockett and, you know, Tom Sawyer and stuff like that. You watch it like that with that kind of lighting and performances and things, and it actually does feel like a fun movie. But to me, as a comic book fan, it really missed the mark with the character, which has always just been one of the most just kind of dark and badass characters ever in comics. So we were really happy talking to the guys over at Sony that everybody seemed to be on our page of, we want you to totally reinvent this thing and give us the Ghost Rider that people really want to see.
George, one thing that crossed my mind as I was looking at this, I'm going to go out on a limb. I haven't talked to anybody at Fox Studios about this, but I'm going to go out on a limb and guess that Fox is not done making comic book movies. What do you think Fox would have been surprised? Do you think they're shocked or a little surprised or maybe a little dismayed to hear a director of one of their upcoming films saying stuff like this, knowing that Fox wants to go ahead and probably make more comic book movies after this?
Look, it all comes down to money. If the movie's going to make money, the studios don't seem to care if they're good or bad. They're gonna make a sequel, and that's fine with me. You know what? If you make a bad movie like Ghost Rider, it makes money. Do a sequel that's going to be even better. I think another reason, like what Mike was talking about on why the superhero genre is not going to go away is because comic books just have become more accepted in mainstream society, I think. I mean, look at, you know, things like Comic-Con that get sold out and get bigger and bigger every single year. You know, geek culture has taken over. The storylines are more complex. There's just a lot more for adults to soak in, and it's not really looked at as a kid's medium anymore. So I think that's another reason why superhero films are going to be around for a long, long time. As far as Fox looking at, you know, making more superhero, but like I said, I don't think they're going to want to give up the properties that they have. They're going to keep making movies. They're going to keep making money, whether they're good or bad. And we're going to find out, you know, with X-Men First Class. And I'm not worried about Ghost Rider 2. I'm actually pretty confident that this one's going to be a badass take on the character that we've grown up reading.
Well, listen, guys, that's all the time we have. Thank you guys so much for joining us. I've been George, joined, ladies and gentlemen, by George Roush, El Guapo from Latino Review, Mike Sampson from JoeBlow.com, and, of course, Mr. Brian Taylor of the upcoming film Ghost Rider 2. Gentlemen, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks, John.